Hi friends, here in this video we are going to see the LMTD formula for parallel flow heat exchanger. So let's get started. I'll draw the diagram of the parallel flow heat exchanger first. Here is a parallel flow heat exchanger. This heat exchanger is basically a hollow tube in which in the inside tube there is a hot fluid which is flowing from left towards right, having inlet temperature THI, exit temperature THO. Then above that tube there is a cold fluid which is flowing, having inner temperature or inlet temperature TCI and exit temperature is TCO. Since both the fluids are flowing along the same direction, it is called as the parallel flow heat exchanger. Now, just below this heat exchanger, I would be drawing the temperature distribution or the temperature profile for the parallel flow heat exchanger. On y-axis, we have temperature. On x-axis, we have the length of the heat exchanger. Hot fluid is entering from left side. It would be having greater temperature at the start, and the temperature goes on continuously reducing along the length of the heat exchanger for the hot fluid, entering at temperature of THI, leaving at THO. So this is the temperature variation for the hot fluid along the length of the heat exchanger. Next, for the cold fluid, it would be entering at a lower temperature, which is indicated as TCI. Then the temperature of the cold fluid goes on continuously increasing along the length of the heat exchanger, and the exit temperature is TCO. So here it means that the hot fluid is losing its heat and the cold fluid is gaining the heat. So there would be temperature drop for the hot fluid and temperature gain for the cold fluid. Next, at inlet, the temperature difference is indicated as delta T1. At exit, it is delta T2. Then I'll write the formula of heat transfer for this parallel flow heat exchanger, that since the total rate of heat transfer is given by the formula Q is equal to U into A into the temperature difference, which is the temperature of hot fluid minus the temperature of cold fluid. U indicates the overall heat transfer coefficient. So this is the formula of heat transfer, which is the total heat transfer rate. Now, therefore, in this heat exchanger, I am considering a small length along the temperature profile. Here I am taking a small length of the heat exchanger denoted as dx, that is, instead of the complete length L, I am taking a small length dx, and I'll analyze the heat exchanger for this small length. So here, at a distance of small x from origin, there is the length dx, and when we see over this length dx, the temperature of the hot fluid is going on decreasing along the length of the heat exchanger. So it would be taken as negative. If we see here, there is drop in the temperature of the hot fluid. We have to analyze along the length. So the temperature difference for the hot fluid denoted by dTh for this small length dx will be negative. This dTh value would be negative because the temperature is falling along the length of the heat exchanger for the hot fluid. But when we see for the cold fluid, along the length of the heat exchanger, the final temperature is more, initial temperature is less. So it is gaining the temperature. It means dTc, the change in temperature for the small length dx for cold fluid, would be positive. So dTh is negative. Why it is negative? Because along the length, the final temperature is less. So final minus initial will give us the negative value. Whereas for the cold fluid, final temperature minus initial temperature will give us a positive value. Now, after that, small amount of heat transfer. Over length dx would be given by, denoted by dq, u area will be dA, and the temperature difference would be delta T. This I'll keep it as equation first. That is the small change in heat transfer along the length dx, u into area dA into the temperature difference of hot and cold fluid denoted by delta T. Next, after this, there is another concept, like since heat lost by hot fluid is equal to the heat gained by the cold fluid, so therefore the heat lost by the hot fluid is given by m dot h into specific heat of hot fluid into the temperature difference of hot fluid, which is THI minus THO, is equal to the heat gained by the cold fluid is mass flow rate of cold fluid, specific heat of cold fluid, and temperature change for the cold fluid TCO, the exit temperature is greater. So TCO minus TCI would be the temperature difference. Therefore, m dot h into CPH, this product is called as the heat capacity CH, and THI minus THO, I'll write it as it is. Similarly, for the cold fluid, m dot c into CPC is the capacity for the heat capacity for cold fluid, TCO minus TCI. Also, it can be written as CH into this temperature difference of hot fluid is dTh, and for the cold fluid it is dTc. Now, after reaching up till here, we can say that since the total temperature difference would be the temperature difference of hot fluid minus the temperature difference for cold fluid, differentiating it, or we can say differentiating, or in other words, differentiating for small length dx, because this temperature difference is for the entire heat exchanger. So for a small length, it would be dT is equal to dTh minus dTc. Therefore, now dTh value, as we know, it will come out to be negative, and if I write it in the form of Q, like here I have written m dot h into CPH, THI minus THO, so all these terms are equal to Q. So therefore, I can also say that this is equal to Q. So CH value, or this entire term is called as dTh, that is also equal to Q. So dTh would be, when I write it, CH into dTh is equal to Q, so it would be Q upon CH, and it would be minus because since the temperature of the hot fluid goes on decreasing, similarly for the cold fluid, DTC would be equal to Q upon CC, that is for the cold fluid, and it is positive because the temperature of the cold fluid goes on increasing continuously. So therefore, and this I'll write it as dq, because that is the small amount of heat transfer for the small length dx. So finally this would become dt is equal to, instead of dt I'll write down dth, I'll write down minus dq upon ch, since this is negative, and here dtc would be dq upon cc. In the next step I would be taking minus dq as common, so therefore one upon it is ch minus one upon cc, so that would become plus one upon cc if I take negative common. So we have minus dq 1 upon ch plus 1 upon cc. Now this small amount of heat transfer from equation 1, it can be written as, it is u dA delta T, as we see over here. So it is minus u dA into delta T, and here we have 1 upon ch plus 1 upon cc. So therefore I'll write down separating the variables just before integrating it. Now the variables are temperature and area, overall heat transfer coefficient, heat capacity are constant values. So therefore it would be dt upon delta T minus u into this entire bracket will remain same, integration of dA, here first I'll write it as dA as it is, then I would be integrating it. So I've separated the variables. Now integrating on both sides, so we have integration of dT, that is 1 upon delta T, and the limits are delta T1 to delta T2 minus u 1 upon ch plus 1 upon cc. dA is its integration, and finally this integration of dA would become capital area. So 1 upon delta LT, delta T, the integration is ln of delta T, and when I put the limits it would be, so therefore ln of delta T2 after putting the limits upon delta T1 is equal to minus u. Now 1 upon ch value, if we are writing for the total section, then since ch is THI minus THO into Q, so from this I can say that therefore ch value will be Q upon THI minus THO. So now instead of CH I am going to put this value. So in the numerator we are having, since it is minus U, so minus U 1 upon CH, and CH is Q upon THI minus THO, so it is into the denominator, it would be Q, and in the numerator THI minus THO, then plus, now CC would be written as, by using the same equation, heat capacity for the cold fluid, Q upon TCO minus TCI. So I am putting the value of CC. Therefore this will remain as it is, the left hand side. Now Q would be taken common, and here we are having area as well. So minus U, the integration of dA is capital A, minus UA upon Q. Now I would be combining the terms. For example, THI minus TCI, and then we are having minus THO plus TCO. Now I would be combining the temperatures by looking into the temperature profile. Like at inlet we are having THI and TCI, these would be combined, and similarly here THO and TCO would be combined. So I would write this in such a way that THI minus TCI minus would be taken common, then into the bracket we have THO minus TCO. Now this is minus UA upon Q. When I interchange, that is make the reciprocal of this, it would be negative, that is ln of delta T1 upon delta T2. So when I make this reciprocal, there is a negative sign, so this both the negative sign they get cancelled out. THI minus TCI is nothing but delta T1, THO minus TCO is delta T2, so it is delta T1 minus delta T2, the temperature difference at inlet, and here the temperature difference at exit. So Q, I'll shift it on one side. So finally Q, when shifted over to the other side, will give me this UA into delta T1 minus delta T2 divided by ln of delta T1 upon delta T2. Now this entire term is called as the LMTD, the logarithmic mean temperature difference, since we are having the log term here. So the final equation would be written as Q is equal to UA LMTD. So this is the LMTD formula or equation for a parallel flow heat exchanger. And what is LMTD here? It is delta T1 minus delta T2 upon ln of delta T1 upon delta T2, where delta T1 is THI minus TCI at inlet, delta T2 is THO minus TCO at exit. And this LMTD formula for parallel flow heat exchanger would be used in the problem if out of the four temperatures, any three temperatures are given, that is at least the two inlet temperatures and any one of the exit temperatures are given, then only we can use the LMTD formula. Otherwise, if only two temperatures are known, then we have to use the NTU method. So in this video we have seen the derivation for LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you'll can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.